Gamerz.
All right, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another episode of Tavern Gamerz. We're going to be back for our second coverage of a new Grand Arena that just launched. So this is going to be round one, and we'll kind of get right into it here. So now that I've gone out of Carbonite, Bronzium, or close to getting out of Bronzium here, I'm getting matched up with some pretty strong people at this point. Our first round opponent is going to be very difficult to win. Hopefully we can keep it close. I'm going to just show you what he's got here. And in hindsight, I probably made some mistakes on this. I'll walk you through kind of my thought process. So this guy has a really strong squad arena, Darth Revan team. He's got Malak here. You know, he's got two gear 13 guys, so this lineup alone is going to be a beast. Now, I checked his speed runes on this, and my god, it's fucking fast. Faster than mine. So, one-on-one, if my Darth Revan went against his, he would beat me. So, I know, pretty much hands down, I can't beat his Darth Revan squad. He's just a little faster than me. Mine's, I think, 313. He's at 316. So, I lose the speed battle, plus he's got Malak. So, there's just no way I'm beating that squad. So he's also got Jedi Knight Revan, he's got Treya, you know, Palpatine obviously, he's got Bossk, he's got Night Sisters, he's got a decent Old Republic team, he's got Sith Marauder who hits like a truck, so I mean he's got some shit here. Definitely not someone to take lightly. Now, I noticed he did have Nihilus as well, so I try to factor that in on where I'm going to position my nest. So I'll give you my thought process here as I was laying out my defense here, and again, I could have done it better. Hindsight is 2020. So let's just get into it. So what I did to start off, and I'll let you know what I should have done probably, I put my first order on D, I put my Night Sisters with Nest, trying to bait out his Palpatine squad here, just through Bossk as well. And the front line down here, and then here's just my shitty Old Republic thing special. Now, he did get through everything except for my Revan team, so I'm curious what he used on offense and defense later on, because we haven't passed his wall. So I kind of expected the Darth Revan. I was just hoping he was using it for offense in case he was going for a full clear. So I pretty much can't touch this or this wall behind. So that at this point, I already know that. I have to just clean out his top line, which isn't too strong here, and hope for this win at the back. I'm going to use underside squats, and hopefully I can at least maybe get the win by undersquatting it and getting a few extra points, because I'm not full clearing it, let's be realistic. Now, had I known he would have done that, and I should have trusted my gut, I should have perhaps thrown my own Darth Revan on defense and just left another wall for him, so he wouldn't been able to clear it, so one cancels the other, and then I would have had at least maybe a bit better of a score. And if he did wipe out my Darth Revan with his, it's one for one. He would have wiped it out anyways, but at least I know he would use it, so it's not a big loss. So next time, if you're in a position where you know you can't beat their best squad, potentially just use your best squad on defense. It might get you the win there. So that's my kind of advice after all this. Now let's get into this. We're going to fight the Phoenix squad. I'm going to possibly do Wampa by itself here. I've done this before and it crashed and burned, but that was a much stronger Phoenix squad and my Wampa wasn't as strong. So we're going to try Wampa by himself here. Now this hopefully goes well for me, but you never know. Sometimes my crazy ideas don't always pan out, so let's see if this is one of those nights. Alright, start the battle. Well, that was a quick backup plan. I'm gonna try to go for their Hera here. But Wampa's just a beast. God bless him. And he does double damage against rebels, so... Alright, let's just take this out. Then I'm gonna go for... Sabine. Actually, let's do that real quick. There we go. Big hits. So game, set, match pretty much on this one. Alright, 63. That might just get us the win here. I mean, I gotta just beat every squad now with less. So he's got Phoenix. I'm gonna save my Darth Revan just in case. Kinda wanna use Palpatine here. Maybe like Palpatine, Thrawn. Alright, let's go with Vader. Let's hold it. Maybe we just go Sion and Nihilus. That's probably just enough. Alright, let's do it. Let's get the stun train going, so... Alright, 2 wasn't the greatest, but I really need to focus their Tyler because she's weak. Let's just fracture massage for a moment. For Daka now. Yeah, the revive is very annoying. I'm just gonna increase the cooldowns at this point. Get Palpatine going. There we go. That's a decent stun. Alright, Super Saiyan Sion now. He's going to hit like a truck. Let's just one-shot the Asajj. Clear the buffs. Alright, lost one. So not the greatest here. That might have cost me the first round. Okay, so he's got a decent Old Republic squad. I'm gonna run my Darth Revan. We'll run Fallen. HK. It's probably enough, but they do have decent gear and power level, so we'll run it like this. We'll run with 4 and hope for the best. But he cleared all my guys in one try except for my one squad, so I don't know if this is going to get me the win. I may have to run it without the Sith Trooper. Yeah, because I'm going to be 3-4 points under, and I need to make up for that, so this has to work for me. Alright, let's do it. Let's get all the debuffs on. Alright, big hits on this one. Can we just finish him clean here? Then we might. That's what we need. Alright, 62. Okay, not bad, not bad. Was it enough? I don't think it's enough, though. I think we lost this by a few points. Yeah. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, he full cleared me on, too. So, either way, we would have lost it. But for next time, yeah, I could have mixed it up on D. He cleared pretty much everything, but... You learn from Grand Arena. Not every plan works out, but it was a fun first round. He's probably gonna continue on. I don't see why he's not gonna get first. So I'm gonna be fighting for second place, or third, whatever the case. So on to the next round. Thanks for watching, and I'll be back in a few days. All right, and we're back for another round of the Grand Arena, round two. So as we kind of left off on the last one, we lost the first round. Hopefully we can come back, get a little win streak going, and maybe just finish out winning the next two matches. So, round two, we're going to go against this guy. I'll just quickly show you what he has. He's kind of like running a similar lineup to what I am. Nihilus. I have Slam. My HK is not geared up enough. He's got CLS. Darth Revan. Night Sisters, Bosk, I mean Empire, or Palpatine, First Order, some Jedi, so kind of a similar roster. He's got Nest as well. And just a quick review. I can't even show that. Oh, you can't, nice. Alright. So yeah, he couldn't get through my Revan, but he wiped everything else out, as you saw before, and I struggled. So just for those of you that maybe missed the first round. Okay, so on defense, what I put my Revan squad, my Bosk. I figured he wouldn't be able to beat my Darth Revan, so I threw it on defense. Back here is just a shit lineup of Phoenix. Back here I put First Order. So he has a decent CLS squad in the front. And a slightly underpowered Jedi. But Jedi again are very strong, and he's got Bindo, so definitely can't underestimate the Jedi. And First Order, we know, can make it interesting, so... What I was thinking, I'll leave CLS for now. I have a feeling possibly my Vader Wampa can beat this, but that's a maybe. I just want to see what's behind this wall here, so we're going to clear this out first. Alright, so here I'm going to use Palpatine. There's Palpatine, Sion, Nihilus. Perhaps do Tarkin here. And what would be our next one? Yeah, we don't really need Imperial Probe Droid. Yeah, it would have been nice if I had Thrawn. I'll just go with TIE Fighter. So we gotta secure the win here. And he's got pretty decent speed mods, as you can see. If we can kill Yoda, it'll be in a good spot. If not, this is gonna be looking quite terrible. This is not looking good. good. Maybe I should have brought in the droid. We got two taunters. That's quite annoying. Using him and I hate going against him. It's just pretty damn strong. There we go. Holy shit, now we gotta go for Bindo. Before he revives Yoda. Oh my god. So gross. Okay, we have to annihilate this. Hopefully finish off Yoda here. Focusing on Bindo. We got this. We got the win, wasn't pretty, but you never know with Yoda just one-shotting guys, it's a pretty annoying matchup. Alright, so that's done. So here again, we're gonna use CLS, and hopefully it's not as hairy as the last time we were doing this. I'm probably gonna get rid of Biggs and use Nest. And I just pray that this, I don't regret this. I want to save again Vader Wampa if needed. Yeah, don't underestimate First Order. As you can see, the last one is basically a matchup with Kylo Ren and my Commander Luke. So I want to be in that spot again. Maybe stun Kylo and go for the officer here. And we'll get some burning one. Get rid of those taunts. Alright, Alright, not perfect, but it's a win. We just need to go for the win. Hopefully he's just got a shitty squad in the back I can take care of. Alright, that's actually not too bad. Still feel like CLS is stronger here. Who would I even send on this? I mean, I want to save my Vader. Yeah, that's a tough call. Alright, let's try for CLS just because I got Wampa. This may be a disaster and I'm probably going to regret it, but I feel like I got to go for the big play here. He's pretty fast. Alright, I'm not feeling too confident about this. Like, he's got a decent mod set on CLS here. He's got pretty good speed as well. If I had Thrawn, I'd feel a lot better, but... It's also got these two, so I know I'm going to be going through their tanks, they're going to be healing, these guys are going to be just pouncing on me. I mean, even with Wampa, it's going to be close. Yeah, this is a toss-up, and maybe what's behind CLS's squad's not that strong. Alright, let's go for it. I mean, we're not fighting for first, not that I want to lose, but at the end of the day, we gotta go for it, I think. Maybe we'll do two taunts. We'll get Royal Guard and Old Pen. Where's Old Pen? Let's try like this. Oh god. Yeah, I'm regretting this already. Should have gone with my gut instinct on this, so we'll clear all our blocks, but it's already a little bit too late. Wow. Alright, so this is a complete failure. Yeah, I should have stayed away. I got baited in by my Wampa, dammit. That was my bad. We definitely need to at least clear this out to have a chance here. I'm gonna use Night Sisters and hope for the best. Thank you. out of here. Real folks, gonna look for better things on round three, but definitely we're off to a bad start. That might have just, that decision to go for CLS, I think it just cost us here. I really don't have anything else I can throw at this. I mean, I have Imperial Troopers, but that's not gonna, it's not gonna really do it. Alright, well, it's pretty much a loss, so thanks for watching. We're gonna be back for round three. Hopefully I can redeem my honor, but definitely it's been a tough round, the Grand Arena this time around. We'll be back for the next one. And we're live, we're round, welcome everyone for Tavern Gamerz. We're here in round three of the Grand Arena. It's gonna be a struggle to at least get a win, so hopefully I can not disappoint. I got my brother here to join the show. Yeah, I mean, Arthur's not into this game yet, but maybe he'll learn a thing or two and have some fun along the way.
Yep, hope to see this gameplay.
Here we go, and we're going to see it in good quality. So we're, again, round three, we lost the second round and the first round. This is the first time in my Grand Arena history I've lost both rounds. So we're basically fighting for pride here, not to finish last. So here we're going to start off. So we're against Overload. He's got a... I guess a kind of underpowered clone trooper squad, so that won't be too hard. Boring old Phoenix, which Wampa will devour, hopefully. And then he's got a half-decent bounty hunter squad, so we're probably going to throw Palpatine at that. And I kept Thrawn just in case. So on defense, I got my Revan, just so you guys can see. I got my Jedi Knight Revan. Bless you. I got my bounty hunter, similar to his squad, on defense. Got my Revan squad, put in Nest in case he's using Palpatine against me. And my backline's simple, just got my Old Republic, and I probably have Phoenix here. Yeah, boring Phoenix, there we go. Alright, let's get off into it. We're gonna start off with the top side, and we're gonna go for the Bounty Hunter. So we'll use Palpatine, Thrawn, Nihilus, Scion, and could be rounded out with, I forget who I usually use, I think it's Tarkin. Yeah, I think it's Tarkin. Alright, let's get it going here. Have you watched much of the Star Wars movies, or any of the recent
movies? No, I'm not a Star Wars fan.
Okay, so he's a complete non-Star Wars fan. Hopefully we can convert him in this video, but if not, it'll be a lifelong struggle for that. Alright, so we're gonna fracture the boss. Put on 2 speed, so you can see it. Because you only get 5 minutes to make a battle, and you don't have too much time. So we're gonna try to wipe out Boba Fett, I guess, since we've already fractured boss. Some shock, auto-attacking. Block most of their guys right now. Alright, let's get a good stun here. Alright, I'll take it. 2 of their guys are stunned. I mean, it doesn't always work out, but...
So, you see on the screen with this,
They're flashing?
Yeah.
They're stunned. That means they can't... On their turn, they don't attack. They don't do anything. It's like they skip a turn.
Yeah,
that's
pretty good.
I'm gonna finish off, Bubba here, let's get rid of all those buffs. Green are the buffs, red are negative effects.
Yeah.
And we're gonna just keep focusing on their Bubba Fett here. We're increasing cooldown, so their abilities take longer to trigger. And we're gonna swap some turn meter with Nihilus. I want him to annihilate. So that was a two-turn cooldown. So when I use this, I can one-shot one of their guys.
Yeah.
Just eliminate them. And that's the idea. We're on a bit of a time crunch, but 3 minutes. I'm going to try to speed up my pace. Big auto attack there. That's good. Get some debuffs. And Bubba's going down soon. Bubba's down for the count. Alright, so now let's finish off Cad Bane, and we're going to one-shot the Bosky over here. Alright, I'll take that's pretty much game set match. We'll quick finish Greedo. Fracture Boss. So a pretty easy matchup. You can use Palpatine against Bounty Hunters. Alright, one shot. He's gone. I can pretty much auto this, but I want to get max points. Not that it matters. I mean, let's be real, you're fighting for like not finishing last. But you don't want to be sloppy at the same time either.
So wait, he was stunned, right? His last character, Dengar?
Yeah. No, Dengar was invisible. Like, before I couldn't target him, he was invisible.
Oh.
But once everyone dies, you can target him if he's invisible.
Alright. So you got this game in the bag.
This match. So I didn't get perfect score. I would have got 60 or higher, but I'll take 57. Again, it's just a matter of not losing the tournament, so more for pride at this point. So we're gonna go against Phoenix. We knocked him out. Now we got a chance to. We don't see what's back here until we wipe out their full front. So we're gonna go ahead and fight their Phoenix squad. That's their overall power level. So you can see this was much stronger. And I'm gonna try something that might be a little reckless. I'm gonna use just Vader, Darth Vader, and Wampa. Two guys. We're going 2-on-5 here. I know it sounds crazy, but Wampa usually does the trick, so...
Wait, why are you going to only use two? Why
you get more points for using
so
less.
It's kind of like a risky strat. High risk, high reward.
It is, but if you do it and you lose, or let's say you lose, you don't finish with perfect health or protection, it's almost the same as just beating them 5-on-5. But I trust Wampa, I trust Vader. I think I got it. If this crash and burns, it's my fucking... It's because I had some hot sauce, I'm not thinking straight.
So what's with the stars?
Oh, so quickly, yeah, the stars are your max. So this is the max you can have is 7. That just makes their stats stronger. But it takes time to farm them to 7 stars. You have to like get shards of the character and keep leveling them. It just takes time to do. Alright, so Wampa, he's good against Phoenix because he does double damage against Rebels, and they're all Rebels. So we're going to throw some debuffs right now. They're all hit. Wampa's gonna do his thing. And he starts doing more damage every time. So this first hit's not the most, but it starts doing more and more. Let's see if we can one shot this. Alright, Wampa's bigger hits here. Yeah, every time he's hitting harder.
Wait, is that R2?
No, that's the other one, Chopper's, the shittier one. Alright, so he's gone. Chopper's gone. We gotta go through Jarvis because he's taunting. Green thing, you gotta go through. So you can't attack anyone else because he's taunting. I gotta keep hitting him until the taunt goes on. Wampa's gonna hit him really hard here, I hope. Not one shot, but he's gonna hit hard. Any counter attacks. There you go, 41,000 Wampa. So that's the beauty of the beast. So I wanna wipe her out because she can bring people back with her spells.
Yeah.
Like, if you kill them, they come back, so that's why I try to focus
on. Oh, and what's with these two on the screen right here?
So he's got counterattack?
Yeah.
Or that's his special. I did the Howl, so I got protection, counter chance, offense, tenacity, and this stat. So that's the Zeta you put on him, he gets extra abilities.
Yeah.
So he's going to start hitting really hard soon. Look at that, 53,000 one shot. From a counter, so that's pretty much game set match. The power of Wampa, really. There we go. More debuffs. Throw the Culling Blade. So the more effects he has on him, when I throw this Culling Blade, it removes all those effects and does more damage for every spell removed. Then I get turn meter on the finishing blow. So.
Nice.
62. So now I got max points here. I'm at 62 rather than, what, 57 I got? So this worked out. The last time I've done this, and their Phoenix squad is really strong and I actually lost it, so You gotta know when you can pull off a move like that. Alright, so now we get to see what's back here. So he's got a Jedi squad. Pretty decent here. He's got gear 13 on Yoda. And Yoda's OP, he's got a good squad. So I don't know if we can beat that with what I have left. I used kind of my best stuff already. So we'll come back to that.
Oh, and what does attack phase mean? Because it says 22 hours.
So you have 24 hours to do your defense, which I did yesterday. Then you have 24 hours to attack. It opens up after 24 hours. So this whole tournament takes, 6 days, basically.
Yeah. But what is the reward for it?
The prizes, like gear, items, money.
How good is it, though? That's the problem.
It's a fun tournament, but if you come in first, you get more than coming in second or third or whatever. So first is obviously the best prize.
So which one are you going to do first? Are you going to attack?
We're going to go for the shitty squad. I don't think I can take that right now. I want to see what he's hiding behind here.
A bunch of troopers?
Yeah, they got some troopers. I think my first order could probably do it. I think. I hope. Alright, let's try my first order. Maybe I'm wrong. Let's try it. So we're gonna go to first order. They're about evenly matched. So we're gonna try this.
Now what would happen if you lost this tournament?
Well, I'm already fighting for like 6th or 7th place here, so I'm just going to get less of a payout.
Right.
And I get less like total points for Grand Arena, like your rank. So I don't get as much, but I'm getting paired against guys really good right now for my level, so the further you go, the harder it gets. So I'm going to try to take out Rex first. He's the captain or... So we're gonna try to work.
The only real thing I know about Star Wars is one time I watched a YouTube video and it was this funny video on Exegy Order 66 from the movie, but instead they give all the audio, and instead there's the song by Aha Take On Me is playing. Yeah, that's probably the most funny of Star Wars I've ever seen.
Well, that's kind of sad to hear, but hopefully we'll convert you in the future. Okay. I created one for one. I really want to get rid of stupid Rex. Yeah, because he removes his debuffs, so he's getting close to dying. Rex here. Alright. Him.
So which one do you think is the second one you
got to get rid of? I kind of want to get through an eco.
Why? This is
I think he does a bit more damage than the other guys, so I pretty much have the match here. I don't think they're winning.
When one of your guys
you get less points for winning that fight or losing.
But they're still on your inventory.
Yeah. But you can't use them for that event. Like, the event's over, that's it. You lose them. You attack and put certain things on defense, offense. Once you use it, that's it. Regardless of what happens. Alright, so that guy's gone. We're gonna just finish this off. Some basics. I can't even slow it down. We really want to see the animations, you guys. Pretty crisp, huh? 60 frames right there. Game, set, match. So, I lost the guy, so I didn't get a high score there, right?
But you still got something.
I got something, just not like... Awesome. Sometimes you can win just by beating the other guy's high score. Like, you both finish at like a certain amount, but you win by a few extra points. Yeah. And that's the difference between using an underpowered squad or beating it a lot clearer. Let's see his Night Sisters. Ooh, that's really strong. Yeah, I definitely can't beat that, what I have left.
Now, you mind telling me, after you beat it, there's this reward system and it gives you...
I'll show you.
What is the 100k thing? Is it points or experience?
100k? The power? Squad power?
I don't know. After it says, there's this kind of triangle or some sort of golden thing and it says 100k.
Like this?
I don't know. Just beat another round and...
Alright. That's just the score you get for that fight. Alright, we're gonna try the Jedi, and I doubt I can beat this right now because I'm gonna be using my CLS squad. It can win, but he's definitely got a decent one as well. So definitely I'm not gonna be able to beat Night Sisters, so I'm not even gonna try.
Alright, so you're gonna wait until you kill the Night.
I'm gonna just go for this. If I don't clear it in one shot, I'll use some remaining squad, but they are very strong. So, we're gonna stun. Yoda. Let me speed up the two at least, alright. I'm gonna remove Basilisk turn meter. Oh, I didn't even go through. Alright. Make everyone invisible, they gotta focus my loop. Remove all the buffs. All these buffs, I'm gonna get rid of them. Or some of them anyways. The ones that locks, that have locks, they can't remove.
So wait, when it turns invisible, it can't...
They can't focus it. Unless they use like an AoE spell. But they can't like click, they can't like click on you like this. Right now we're gonna vote for Yoda, I think. Yoda needs to die. He's their biggest damage though. I kill Yoda, I have the match. I'm gonna keep focusing. Now he's giving everyone more buffs. Very annoying. Yoda's still broken. Luke's gonna... now he's invisible too. He stole my... Yeah, that's quite annoying.
So they're gonna kill Luke, but...
I think I'm losing Luke here.
Is he that good or not?
He is very good.
He's
my leader. Oh god. And this is where it all falls apart. Yeah, it's a very good squad. They don't... Jedi Revan's not required for your Jedi. As long as you have Basilisk, it's still very strong. So now he's taunting. I have to attack him. They have protection up, so I can't really put any debuffs on them.
What is tenacity?
Resistance against negative effects. So that's like tenacity up right there. They all have it. So overall, it's just an annoying fight, and I don't think I'm winning at this point.
I don't
know. He's giving them all buffs again. Yeah, this just gets worse. I need to cleanse, but it's two turns before I can cleanse them.
Cleanse
the
what?
Removes all the green effects, all the positive effects, it removes them.
But negative effects, what?
Well, good for me, bad for them. I got red on me, that's bad.
Oh, it's
which one?
It's a fist.
It's tenacity. So if you click on it, it'll tell you what to do. I don't know why it's not showing me. Yeah, this is pretty much over.
Why aren't you attacking Yoda?
Can't, he's taunting. I'll be lucky if I even kill one of their guys. Yoda just does so much damage, so that's the thing. If I can kill Yoda, at least Yoda, I have a chance. But
yeah.
He just gives everyone buffs, he does massive damage, he attacks many times a turn. Like, look at these hits, one shot.
So he's like a witch, basically.
I don't know about a witch, he's just a... heavy hitter, he's the Mike Tyson who knocks shit out.
Yeah, so the difference is Mike Tyson doesn't give you tenacity.
Well, he gives everyone on this team all these benefits. Well, Basila throws it on him, and then he throws it on everyone else. It's a really dirty combo.
You think
yeah.
You should use the more powerful
squad? Well, I use my best stuff on defense, because I don't think he's going to beat my squads. So... he kind of did a somewhat similar strat, but he put his best guys, or not his best, but he put some good squads on defense in the back. I don't have anything that can beat this at this point, so I'm stuck with my shitty Night Sister squad, my Imperial Troopers. Like, these are my good squads are already used. So I'm left with an underpowered Night Sister squad.
Yeah.
And I'm left with some shitty, like, Imperial Troopers that are way underpowered. And if you lose the fight, the worst thing is... they have preloaded turn meter, so they basically get to go again right before you get to do anything. They're already attacking like the whole turn ahead of you. This is pretty much over. I'm gonna leave it at that. I don't see myself beating either of these, and I'll keep you guys posted. I mean, again, I'm just fighting for not finishing last at this point. So it's been a tough Grand Arena, but thank you for watching. We'll be back for more exciting content later on. And anything else you wanna add? I think we're good.
Keep posted because me and my brother Russell, we may do a
retro,
not retro night, or we could do a new game of the night, either or.
New flavor of the week. Let's play a game Russell's never tried before. Huh?
Yeah, and something I've completely either understood, or hell, maybe we can just try something new together.
Yeah, no, it's definitely on the table. So you know, stay tuned, like and subscribe if you haven't already, and thanks for watching. Take care, everyone.